Welcome to a new occasional series where I reveal the amazing planet we call home using satellites, drones, and microscopes. I'm Ariel Waldman. I've made a career out of exploring the world below our feet and beyond our atmosphere. And I want to take you along for the ride as I unearth the weird and whimsical wonders that are all around us. Welcome to Order of Magnitude. On this episode, I explore a nook nestled within the San Francisco Bay Area in Northern California. San Rafael Bay lines the small town of San Rafael, just north of San Francisco. The bay is notably host to two tiny islands, together only 10 acres in size. The Marin Islands are part of the San Francisco Bay National Wildlife Refuge, providing a nesting habitat for many herons and egrets. I was able to stand just across the bay from the two islands to get a closer look.
So today I'm here in the San Rafael Bay, part of the San Francisco Bay Area. And behind me are the Marin Islands, which are part of a wildlife refuge and host a lot of herons and other interesting birds. So I've actually got a little kitty plankton net with me here today. And there's some cool seaweed and everything behind me. And I was thinking of trawling for some plankton and looking at it under the microscope. I don't have my full microscope with me today, so I'm going to try and see what I can see with some tiny microscopes, and we'll go from there. Okay, so I threw my little kid plankton net into the water a few times. This is sort of a plankton net that's shaped like a shark or a fish of some sort. But anyway, I threw it in there a few times and was able to get sort of this the top surface of the water and skim the surface of the water a few times. And I've got a little bit of seaweed in there, but mostly clear water. I can already see there's some things sort of like moving around in it. So it's kind of fun. We'll see what we can see. As I mentioned, I've got sort of my travel microscopes with me, so it might not be the best quality, but we might be able to see some interesting plankton in here to start off with. So let's go look at this under the microscope. All right, so I've got my plankton sample here with a little bit of seaweed in it. I'm going to see if we can find anything in it. It's possible we might not find anything, or it's possible we might find some cool, creepy crawlers. Today, I've got with me my little travel microscope from Bully Optics. It's handheld, really nice, has a little LED light in it that's going to allow me to see some things. In case it's a little too tiny of a microscope to use, I also brought my more bulky Bausch & Lomb stereo zoom microscope. I kind of call this microscope Piglet and my Bausch & Lomb Eeyore, and they're going to help me look at some of the stuff in the plankton sample today. Also just have some easy petri dishes and a pipette. And then one of my favorite tools, which is the lab cam, which is going to allow me to film everything with my iPhone. So let's look. There's some pretty cool stuff down here.
These are definitely some fascinating critters. There's some beautiful pieces of microalgae encased in glass, known as diatoms, and there's a few swimming around that I'm less familiar with. Here's where I want to make this series fun and interact with you. While I look at all sorts of creatures with my microscope, I don't specialize in species identification. I've done my best here to make an estimated guess as to what these creatures are, but I don't always know their exact species or genus, or it's possible I may have misidentified them. But here's what's fun. A lot of times you can make identifications of microscopic creatures by being clever at doing a Google image search for their features. What shape are they? How do they move? What color are they displaying? Have a try and see if you can find identifications that might be close fits and put them in the comments below. Thank you. was a delight to briefly explore the plankton of San Rafael Bay. I have no doubt there are many more tiny critters to discover there, perhaps on a future trip. Thanks for joining me on my latest microbe safari. Until next time, remember to always be exploring.